Hi, everyone. So a lot of people, when they come to our program, they want to go straight into vision therapy because they say that most of their symptoms come from vision. Now, the visual system, it depends on many other systems and it works interdependently with many other systems. And if you're interested in more information, you can go to our website and listen to our podcast on the visual system, vestibular system. You can also read some articles on visual consequences post-concussion, like convergence issues, accommodative issues, and also learn about how these systems relate to the somatosensory system and vestibular system. So I'm going to explain something conceptually so patients understand how all these things come together, how crawling and squats and lunges, how all these things come together in helping you with your vision. And in fact, if you go to our blog, there are two patients we've seen, we wrote about at least, that had binocular vision issues post-concussion and that were completely rehabilitated from it without even using vision therapy. But by using relaxation, by using vestibular therapy, and by using energy management principles and helping them with their sleep, their eyes, the problems with their eyes kind of resolved on its own. And in fact, when you first developed these skills, you did not usually do vision therapy, but they kind of developed naturally through just moving and through doing things and trying things out. So we try to recreate the natural conditions in which someone first develops their visual skills. So if you look at this diagram here, I'm showing like, it's kind of like levels, kind of like trying to reach a height. So vision therapy is on the top shelf, and then somatosensory is on like a bottom shelf. And when you think about it as a child, when you're lying on your back and you're moving your neck for the first time, that's your somatosensory system kind of acting as the flywheel to the rest of the system. And this is why in our video series, we have a lot of emphasis on somatosensory training. And we notice a lot of people improve their balance and dizziness once they learn to ground themselves properly in different contexts. So if you do a really good job at this level, the somatosensory level, then you've kind of progressed to the next level. Now, in this video, I'm kind of like isolating them, kind of pretending like they're all different, but they're actually all kind of intertwined, but our focus is on somatosensory at the beginning. And then if you don't do that great a job in the somatosensory, then you got to kind of make up for it with the other categories, the vestibular, the spatial awareness. And if you fall a little bit short, say like for instance with the somatosensory, you fall here, but you know the vision area is up about here, conceptually I mean, then you know you have to make sure that you really kind of do a good job on these ones. And you might fall short. And often we find people who jump levels and go to vision therapy post-concussion, they do kind of, often they struggle and they kind of don't kind of have the results that they're looking for, or it aggravates their symptoms. So we want to highlight that it's really important to give every level the best shot you have. So really pushing somatosensory. Sometimes we're getting people to do lunges and other kind of things that they never did before. And it's part of that whole idea that when you train something, you want to kind of overtrain it. Like when the orthodontist puts on braces, after the teeth are straight, they keep it on for a while because they don't want to lose that straightness. So same kind of things. We overtrain it a bit. And then on that, then our focus kind of shifts on integrating the somatosensory kind of skills we gave you with vestibular skills, teaching you to become very mindful of what the vestibular system brings to the table and working with that in a way that's good for you and good for your balance. And then after that, we add spatial awareness training. Well, it's already kind of integrated in the previous levels, but our focus is on it. And as our focus is on it, you're learning to integrate all these other things in that context. So that's teaching you to become aware of your peripheral vision and using that to help guide your balance and your movement. And then after that, our focus shifts to being able to stay strong and stay true with what you learn in these first three levels, so that you can resist the temptation to get kind of sucked in by an annoying, obnoxious type visual stimulation. Optokinetic stimulus really technically is kind of like a busy pattern that you can't really kind of pick one spot and latch onto it. It's kind of like those busy Thanksgiving dinner tablecloths, or, you know, if you're lying in the grass and looking up at a summer sky with moving clouds, you know, it's hard to really pick one spot in the sky that kind of orients you. So the same kind of thing here. When you're exposed to something like that, that's called optokinetic stimulus. And to be able to rely on these other skills here that we've heightened through training helps you progress to the next level. And if you are able to push those as far as you can go, you're looking really good when you're going into the vision therapy part of your therapy. And again, I don't want to make it sound like we're separating them and you have to graduate one to go the other. Definitely, they kind of overlap, and sometimes we do a little bit earlier on and come back to it later. But the emphasis and focus should kind of follow this hierarchy. So I wanted to provide this to you as a conceptual way of understanding conceptually why we don't jump straight to vision therapy, but why we slow things down and get people to do like lunges, or, you know, become very aware of how they're moving their body and how they can integrate peripheral vision into their movement and how they can become resistant or resilient in the face of optokinetic stimulation and stimulus and that kind of thing. Hope that was helpful. And if you want more information, more can be had at our website and our podcast episodes.